Director for the Arts. I'm Shani Pierre. I'm the director of the Maison Française, and very pleased to be presenting tonight's film as part of our series on Blackness in French and Francophone cinema, which is co-sponsored by the School of the Arts. Tonight, I am absolutely delighted to be welcoming Alice Diop, who will be here with us to talk about her film Vers la tendresse, Towards Tenderness. And Alice will also be conducting a masterclass on Monday at the Maison Française at 6:30. And that masterclass will be followed by the screening of another film of hers called La Permanence on call. So thank you so much to Alice for being here. She will be introduced at more length in just a moment by Nancy, the curator of the film series, who will also say a word about the film. But I just wanted to take a moment to recognize the other co-sponsors of the series. In addition to the School of the Arts, our other co-sponsors are the Cultural Services of the French Embassy, Institute of African Studies, the Institute for the Study of Women, Gender, and Sexuality, Institute for Research in African American Studies, the Hayman Center, the European Institute, and the Teachers College Office of the Vice President for Diversity and Community Affairs. And I'd also like to thank for their support the Paul Leclerc Centennial Fund, the Knapp Family Foundation, Cultural Services of the French Embassy, and LASCAM. I want to, in particular tonight, thank Gavin Browning and Marcel Forres and Brendan Regenball here at the Memphis Center for all of their help for the screenings today, and another screening we'll have here on Tuesday. I'd also like to thank everyone else who's helped in this series, including Alex Cutler and Marceau Ferrand, and in particular thank Noah Philippe, our curator, and Maboula Soumahoro, who's with us again this evening. So, I know some of you have been to several screenings already, so you already probably know Maboula's bio by heart. But for those of you who are coming for the first time tonight, I just wanted to introduce her briefly. She'll be moderating the discussion after the film. Maboula Soumahoro has been involved since the beginning with this film series with Noah Philippe. She is an invited scholar and guest moderator. She has strong ties to Colombia. She has been here and involved with several departments: the Africana Studies Department at Barnard College, the Institute for Research in African American Studies, the History Department. She's also taught at Bennington College and the Bard Prison Initiative. And she is currently an associate professor in the English department at the University of Tours in France. She's at work on two book projects at the moment. One is called Black People's Black Gods, a comparative historical analysis of the emergence of Rastafari and the Nation of Islam. And the second, which came out of a conference at Columbia, is called Constructing Black France, a Transatlantic Dialogue. And she is also a very vocal and visible presence in France on the radio and the television, and was the co-founder and president of the Black History Month in France, and has been involved as well as a member of the National Committee for the Memory and History of Slavery. So Maboula will be moderating a discussion with Alice after the screening, and joined by a dear colleague, Brent Edwards. So I will just introduce him very briefly as well. I promise to be brief. Brent is a professor in the Department of English and Comparative Literature and the Center for Jazz Studies at Columbia, and the director of the Scholars in Residence Program at the Schomburg Center. He has a number of research and teaching interests, including African-American literature, Francophone literature, theories of the African diaspora, translation studies, archive theory, Black radical historiography, cultural politics in Paris in the 20s and 30s, surrealism, experimental politics, and jazz. That's a lot for one person. I will not go through the full list of his publications, but wanted to mention just a few of them. The Practice of Diaspora, Literature, Translation, and the Rise of Black Internationalism, which won a number of awards. He's also a co-editor of the collection Uptown Conversation, the New Jazz Studies. He's also been the editor of scholarly editions of classic works by Frederick Douglass, Joseph Conrad, W.E.B. Du Bois, and Claude McKay. And he's an incredible translator, including a recent translation of the monumental Phantom Africa by Michel Nyrisse. And his latest book is Epistrophe, Jazz and the Literary Imagination, which has just been awarded the Virgil Thompson Award for Outstanding Music Criticism in the Pop Music Field. Last, I promise it's the last thing I'll say. Current book projects of Brent's include the book Black Radicalism in the Archive, and he's also at work restoring an experimental film called Sweet Willie Roll Bar's Orientation, and has another book project at work on loft jazz in downtown Manhattan in the 1970s. So we look forward to hearing the discussion after the film, which is about 40 minutes. I'm going to turn over briefly to Nora Philippe, who will say a little bit more about Alice Diop and her film. And I'd like to thank all of you for coming. It's been wonderful to see such a great turnout for this series, and wonderful to see so many of you here tonight. So thanks so much, and please join me in welcoming Nora and Alice Diop.
Filmmakers have also long pedigrees and filmographies. So my role is to present briefly Alice Diop that we have the honor to have with us today. She hopped on the plane yesterday. She has a very busy schedule. She is shooting a new film right now, so it's really, really a privilege to have her attending today. Alice Diop has made six films already since 2005, relentlessly journeying and exploring the hearts, the memories, and the territories of the human beings that French society still calls les banlieues. In Clichy, for example, in 2005, Les Sénégalaises et la Sénégaloise in 2007, The Death of Danton in 2011, and encore La Permanence that we will see on Monday night at La Maison Française. And now a new project called Nous, Us, that Alice Diop will present in her masterclass on next Monday afternoon. Each of her films have received multiple awards and have been selected in dozens of international film festivals, from Cinéma du Réel to Doxa in Vancouver, Lusas, to, mark my words, to a César, which is the equivalent of an Oscar, for the very film that we will see today, Towards Tenderness, that she received in 2017. And actually, never a César for a short film had ever been awarded to such an experimental filmic form. Towards Tenderness started as a documentary originally, a trace that its soundtrack bears, and then it became something else, a fiction too, an experimental film. Above all, I think I would like to use the word a poem. I will not say more. Thank you again, Alice Diop. Thank you to Shani, Pierre, and Gavin Brown for hosting the screening. And Alice, if you would like to, I can translate, if you would like to say a few words.
Thank you very much to be here. At the first time, I have to apologize because my English is very, very, very bad. But thank you, Nora. It's a real pleasure for me to be here, and I will be very happy to speak with you after the screening. Thank you very much. Bonne projection.
Two other boys that I did not know at all.
Et donc je les ai enregistrés et même filmés, mais je les ai filmés non pas dans la perspective de faire un film, mais c'était plutôt comme prendre des notes, c'est-à-dire que c'était vraiment une caméra.
So I recorded them, I filmed them, but it wasn't about making a movie about them at first.
Et donc
I was taking notes.
Et je leur ai posé des questions très banales, et comme et toi, comment tu te débrouilles avec les femmes? C'est quoi pour toi la tendresse? C'est quoi pour toi qu'est-ce que tu penses du corps féminin, enfin des questions que
so my questions were very general at first. How do you view women? What's your relationship to tenderness? So very general questions at first.
Et je dois dire que j'ai été absolument bouleversée par leurs réponses. Et voilà, j'étais bouleversée par leurs réponses, et je bouleversée parce que finalement jamais personne n'avait posé ces questions à ces garçons. Et du coup, ce qu'ils m'ont dit, ils avaient besoin de le dire, et c'est ce qui fait pour moi la qualité de ces voix.
So I was totally shocked. I was totally the answers they gave me were very unexpected, and I realized that I had never heard such words simply because nobody ever asked them those questions.
Et donc très vite, j'ai été convaincue que disjoindre le son et l'image, c'est-à-dire de faire entendre ces voix, ces monologues, sans la coller au corps de la personne qui parle, ça allait la faire résonner beaucoup plus haut, et ça allait permettre que ces voix deviennent universelles aussi.
So the decision to split the sound and the images really allowed me to give greater, to emphasize what those men were saying, because there was no association between what they were saying and their own bodies. So I think that this was important, and that this is what brings, this is what adds up to the quality of what is appears on the screen at the end.
Ensuite, quand vous parlez de la, du rapport à la littérature, effectivement, les voix sont, c'est totalement documentaire, mais il y a quelque chose qui est reconstruit dans un travail de montage.
So this is a real documentary, but there is a process of reconstructing the dialogue, the reconstructing the words, and that has to do with what you said about literature.
It also underlines the power, it universalizes, but it also underlines the power in emphasizing a sense of the unsaid, a sense of what nobody is talking about, what nobody is voicing, what this kind of undercurrent that's flowing in these male spaces, in the on the street corner, in the off-track betting, in the convenience store, but that's never voiced. And so it adds a real power to the film. The other formal choice that is striking to me is that you preserve the dialogic aspect. Your voice, I'd even pull away from that. It's because it's the interlocutor. You never show up and you're not identified as the one asking the question. But there's a feminine voice that's woven into the film talking to them. You could have just woven together their voices and made it the voices of the men. But to keep the woman as the person asking questions has a really interesting effect, too. In some ways, it's distancing. You're asking them for information in almost an ethnographic way at some points, but there's also an intimacy to it. And there's even, partly because maybe you knew a couple of them very well, an intimacy of being able to challenge someone, say, when someone says, well, people know that I'm looking for something. When I go up to them, you say, well, that's the way you see yourself. That moment is really interesting. There are moments when you push back, when you challenge them. So there's an intimacy that's woven into the film by the way the woman's voice, even if we're not seeing someone associated with that voice, the way the woman's voice stays there as that dialogic part. And do you want to talk about why you wanted to keep your voice?
C'est très très important et merci de
this is a very important point and thank you for raising this.
Parce qu'effectivement, en fait, on a un ami commun avec Maboula qui s'appelle Rachid Jaidani, qui est un filmmaker, un réalisateur de films. En fait, c'est la première personne à qui j'ai fait écouter les voix.
So we have a friend that Maboula and I know, whose name is Rachid Jaidani, who's a filmmaker as well, and he's the first person I showed the movie to.
Et en fait, c'est Rachid qui m'a fait prendre conscience que ces garçons m'avaient parlé parce que j'étais une femme.
So Rachid Jaidani made me realize that those men, those boys, had spoken to me precisely because I was a woman.
Et ces garçons qui assumaient quelque part une part de leur fragilité devant une femme, ils l'ont fait parce que j'étais une femme. Et jamais ils l'auraient fait avec lui, par exemple.
So those boys allowed themselves to be vulnerable in front of me, precisely because I was a woman. And if I hadn't been a woman, they wouldn't have accepted to do that.
Et du coup, pour moi, il était évident, justement, j'étais pas du tout ni dans une posture de journaliste.
I wasn't a journalist.
Ni dans une posture d'ethnographe ou d'ethnologue.
And I was not an ethnographer either.
Et qu'au fond, cette parole-là, la beauté de cette parole-là, elle existe parce que c'était un homme qui parlait à une femme.
And the beauty of what came out, the beauty of those words, comes from the fact that it was a man talking to a woman.
Et qui a l'opportunité dans cet espace de faire le film de dire des choses à une femme qu'il n'aurait jamais osé dire ailleurs.
And it was the moment, it was the space that allowed those men to say things to a woman that they would never say to a woman outside of this particular space.
Et il y a même des choses extrêmement violentes, par exemple la première voix, Steve. Quand il dit les filles c'est tout des salopes, des putes, je sais plus ce qu'il
so entend. So even violent words, just like the first man we hear, Steve, who says that all women are hoes and bitches.
Le fait de le dire à une femme, quelque part il y avait ça, je trouve que ça révèle aussi la part presque de mise en scène de sa d'une masculinité totalement fictive
so the,
que ça induisait.
The fact that he said that to a woman really shone a light of the. Sorry, can you repeat?
non, le fait qu'il parle à une femme, et que ça révèle, enfin, tu vois, qu'ils disent ces choses aussi violentes à une femme, quelque part, ça révélait le fait qu'on entende la fiction de la masculinité.
So the fact that he was able to say this to me, me as a woman, really revealed the staging, the performance of his masculinity, the performance of his gender. That's precisely what it showed.
The other thing I wanted to ask you to talk about is the title. It's striking to me that it's not called Vers l'amour. It could have been called Vers l'amour. And the term that keeps coming up from the first conversation in all four sections is amour. I think tendresse actually only comes up through the dialogic aspect of the film when the, I think Rachid is the character, says, t'étais en train de parler de la tendresse yet. You were just talking about tendresse in our conversation. Yeah, he says that at one point. I don't think any of them, even the last one, uses the word tendresse. And it's interesting to me because you can be in love without being tender, right? And you can, I think it's fair to say that you can be tender without being love. The two are not synonyms. Tenderness, if I'm not sure that the French word is an exact equivalent for the English word, but let's pretend it is for a minute. To me, tenderness implies an orientation toward the other, and really specifically toward the body of the other, first of all. It's about a kind of physical orientation and a respect and a gentleness with which you approach the embodied other. I just wanted to hear why you decided to call it Vers. I mean, you take us on a trajectory. Certainly, the film takes us from extreme verbal brutality to extreme intimacy and tenderness in that last section of the lovers. But why you decided to call it Vers la tendresse instead of Vers l'amour or something else?
Je crois qu'il y a deux raisons. La première, dans Vers la tendresse, c'est aussi le regard que j'avais envie d'avoir pour eux.
So that's the approach, that's the perspective that I wanted to adopt in watching them, looking at those men.
Ces garçons, ils sont extrêmement maltraités cinématographiquement, ils sont maltraités dans les médias.
In cinema, in the media, those men are really violated, they are really misrepresented.
Et moi, je me souviens même de discussions que j'avais avec ma chef-op, qui en fait était beaucoup plus motivée par régler la technique que réellement de les regarder en fait.
So one of the persons I worked with on this movie was more interested in technical matters than really watching, really observing those men.
Moi cinématographiquement, j'avais envie d'en prendre soin. J'avais envie qu'on ait de prendre soin d'eux et du coup ça impliquait la manière de les filmer.
So I wanted to take care of them. I wanted to cater to them. Cinematically speaking, this is what I wanted to do.
J'avais envie de les je pense que j'avais envie de les regarder avec tendresse pour qu'on puisse les entendre, les écouter. En fait.
I wanted to observe them. I wanted to shoot them with tenderness.
Donc il y a ça et il y a aussi, d'une certaine manière, ce titre qui est un mouvement, c'est aussi ce que je leur souhaitais, c'est-à-dire d'être capable d'assumer leur vulnérabilité, d'assumer la fragilité. Pour moi, la tendresse.
So the title really is about the movement, and this is what I wanted to wish to them. That this is what I was wishing for them to be able to reach tenderness.
Et en fait, de leur montrer à travers le film que effectivement, on peut être dans un hôtel. Je sais pas comment faire formuler, c'est compliqué, mais dans des hôtels un peu très un hôtel.
To cheap hotel. Cheap hotel.
Et de vivre une scène comme ça extrêmement tendre, qui est pas quelque chose de sexuel, qui est pas. C'est juste une. Enfin, à ce moment-là, Anis, il assume ça, presque de se mettre à nu face à la femme qu'il aime.
So I wanted, through the movie, I wanted them to be able to see what was possible, even in the cheapest of hotels. We have this character, we have Anis, who is able to show himself vulnerable and to show himself naked in front of the woman he loves.
Et presque cette scène que je trouve extrêmement tendre.
So this is a tender scene.
Je l'ai tourné à l'intention des deux premières voix. C'était pour leur montrer que quelque chose de ça était possible.
So this particularly tender scene, I shot it so that I could show it to the two first voices to show them that even in such spaces, love, I mean, tenderness, or tenderness was possible.
One other question. There are two moments formally that are, I think, astonishing in the film, and one is the end of the second section. The woman who is behind the window, one of the prostitutes, an extended gaze. I think it's the first moment in the film where a gaze is shared for someone, and she's looking at, almost at the camera. It's really the first time it happens in a very, because it's prolonged, it's a very striking moment, a very powerful moment for me. And then the other really astonishing moment is in that last section, not only the tenderness of the scene, but the conversation. That for the first time, sound is, the film term is diegetic, when the stuff you see on the screen matches the sound being produced. That's the first time it happens. The whole rest of the film, there's voiceover and there are people talking in the grocery store or on the street, but you don't see the person who you're mainly listening to on the voiceover delivering that speech until that moment when they're in bed and he says, "What are you doing tomorrow?" I just wanted to hear you talk about those moments. They're really interesting transitional moments and important choices for them.
C'est drôle parce que ces deux moments, c'est précisément ces deux moments qui font de ce film un film si hybride.
So this is interesting because those two particular moments that you pinpointed are what make the movie such a hybrid movie.
Parce que réellement, enfin, ce film mélange en permanence des choses très fictionnelles et des choses très documentaires.
So this film constantly mixes fiction and documentary elements.
Que j'ai mélangé à tel point que des fois je me souviens même plus qu'est-ce qui est fictionnel, qu'est-ce qui est des films.
And I blended them, those two categories of elements, so much that I don't even remember at times what is fiction and what is documentary.
Mais ce qui est drôle, c'est que dans les projections, les gens pensent que ce qui est de la fiction, c'est du documentaire, et ce qui est du documentaire, c'est de la fiction.
But what is most interesting is that during public screenings, people oftentimes think that what is fiction is documentary, and what is documentary is fiction.
Alors par exemple, la scène de fin, c'est une scène purement documentaire, c'est un vrai couple.
So the final scene is a documentary scene. It was a real couple.
Et la scène avec cette prostituée derrière cette vitrine, non pas le premier travelling qui est lui très documentaire, mais la scène avec cette femme en vitrine, cette reine, ça c'est une fiction. Ça,
and the
fiction.
Scene, the scene with the prostitute looking back at the boys behind the window, this is fiction. She's a comedian.
En français, il y a une expression qui
an actress. An actress.
En français, je sais pas si elle est traduisible. En français, il y a l'expression qui dit tout est bon dans le cochon.
Friends help, friends help, friends help. There's a phrase, there's a saying in French that goes, so literally, first, literally is everything is good in a hug, meaning that you can use, you can make use of anything out of anything.
So
I don't know if anyone here knows the equivalent in English.
Oui, parfait. Non, mais ce que je veux dire, c'est que, mais non, en fait, pour moi, le plus important, c'est d'atteindre la justesse, en fait. C'est d'atteindre, et que cette scène, bien qu'elle soit fictionnelle, en fait, le plus important, c'est qu'elle soit juste et qu'on la vive comme quelque chose, comme un moment de vérité.
I wanted this scene to be just. I wanted to see this scene to be true. And I think that what matters to me is that it can be seen, it can be imagined as real and as true, as just.
Mais ce qui est sûr, c'est que la scène de fin dont vous parliez, ce dialogue n'était pas du tout prévu, en fait. Mm-hmm.
So in the final scene, the conversation was not written at all.
Et je trouvais beau qu'en fait, que la femme, enfin que le réel survienne comme ça de façon inattendue dans le film et que ça finisse par ce dialogue.
It was as if reality broke through unexpectedly in this final scene.
Ça finisse par ce dialogue amoureux entre Alice et sa compagne. C'était comme si le processus avait été accompli en fait. Et du coup, la voix rentrait dans le corps et que cette voix pouvait échanger avec une femme.
This is as if the whole process had been completed and that there could be this reunification of the world, I mean the sound and the image, and maybe tenderness had been reached and by voiced.
I mean, I have more things to talk about, but maybe we should let people ask questions. Another thing I want to ask you about is the music. But
yes, I have questions to ask as well. But I was going to ask questions about music, right? We spoke about perhaps the opposition or the dichotomy or the face-to-face or impossible face-to-face between men and women. But there is no music in the documentary / fiction. But there are two songs. Can you tell us about this music? There are two songs, and I think they can add to our understanding of what is going on.
Moi, c'est vrai que j'ai jamais. C'est la première fois de ma vie que je mets de la musique dans des films.
So I never use music in my films.
Et il y a une artiste que tu connais, qu'on connaît, qui s'appelle Kazé, qui est une artiste qui pour moi est des plus grandes artistes françaises aujourd'hui en termes de voix, en termes de puissance, en termes de ce qu'elle raconte.
So there's an artist that some of you may know here, whose name is Kazé, and who's one of the greatest artists.
Et en fait, ce que j'aime beaucoup, c'est l'ambivalence de sa voix, c'est-à-dire qu'elle a une voix à la fois très masculine et très féminine, c'est-à-dire qu'il y a quelque chose.
And what I love is the ambiguity of her voice. She has a voice that is both masculine and feminine.
Et en fait, quand j'ai commencé à écouter les voix et à me dire que j'allais construire le film à partir de ces quatre monologues.
So when I started thinking about those voices and that I envisioned building, I mean, working on my film. Using those four voices, those four conversations.
Je lui ai demandé d'écrire en fait un texte qui aurait pu être la cinquième voix.
I asked Kazé, the artist, to write a text, to write a song that could be the fifth voice.
Alors je lui ai donné on a travaillé sur des extraits, sur des extraits musicaux, sur des pistes musicales très très particulières. Et en même temps, je lui ai fait écouter les quatre voix et je lui ai demandé d'écrire la cinquième.
So I told her, I asked her to listen to the four voices, the four conversations, and I asked her to write to be the fifth voice of those conversations.
Et quant à la dernière, en fait, au départ, je voulais utiliser un morceau de Archichep qui s'appelle Blasé.
So concerning the last song, the one at the very end of the film, I wanted initially to use Archichep's Blasé.
Mais comme il y avait presque quelque chose d'à la fois hyper violent, parce que moi je suis tellement nul en anglais, mais quand on m'a traduit les paroles, je me suis dit
que it was too violent, it turned out to be too violent, because I don't speak English, but somebody translated the lyrics for me.
Et en fait, c'est mon compagnon, Clément, qui m'a fait écouter ce morceau d'Alain Bachung.
And my partner, Clément, had been listened to this song by a French singer, Alain Bachung,
et qui chante avec sa femme Chloé Mons, et c'est en fait un.
And Alain Bachung is in a duet with his, was in a duet with his wife in
fait,
this song.
Ils ont enregistré le cantique des cantiques.
So they recorded
the song of Solomon.
The song of
Solomon.
The song of Solomon.
The song of songs. You can also say.
Okay.
The song of songs.
But it is
Solomon.
Yeah. Et c'est quand même le premier poème d'amour qui n'a jamais été écrit.
So this is the Song of Songs is the first love poem ever written.
Et donc quelque part, ça me paraissait à la fois de passer de Kazé à Alain Bachung, ça disait quelque chose pour moi.
So to go from rap artist Kazé to French singer Alain Bachung did say something, did reveal something about French music today, contemporary French music.
Et pour moi, il n'y a pas de meilleure façon de finir ce film que par Alain Bachung, par ce.
And there was no better way for me to end the film by this song by Alain Bachung and his wife.
Should we keep going or should we open it up? I can keep going.
I can keep going. No. Okay, so maybe I have the mic. Perhaps you can tell us a bit about your César, the French equivalent to the French Academy Awards, your César experience. You received the César for Best Short I think it was a first because it was a split prize. I don't know if it has ever happened in France. You you had a split prize with a filmmaker, Maboula Soumahoro, who had a very very different short movie. And you are also, both of you, Maboula Soumahoro and yourself, received a French César, I think over 30 years after La Rue Casnègre, the Eusanne Passy. So it was, yes, only the second time that French women and French women, French black women director received a prize. And when you accepted this prize, you made a comment that I think no longer appears in the circulating images of the ceremony. You first said, what's going on? The two black girls are getting awards tonight. Is that a joke? And then you said that you wanted to dedicate this this prize to the men that we never hear about, the men that we never see, the men that we never hear about. And I think it was an interesting, it's an interesting thing to say when we just looked, we just watched the documentary that is called Speak Up, translated as Speak Up, Ouvrir la Voix by Amandine Gay. So you spoke about the men whose voices we never hear, or whose voices we will never hear again. And you spoke about Adama Traoré, who was killed in mysterious conditions that are still not solved by the French gendarmerie. So what made you make those comments when it was supposed to be this triumph, this victory for a black woman, a French black woman director, over 30 years after Eusanne Passy?
C'est vrai que bon, moi j'étais complètement sidérée hein, de recevoir le César déjà, donc d'où ma première impulsion de dire c'est une blague.
So I really did not expect this prize.
Après, c'est vrai que pour repartir de ce César ex aequo, là où j'ai été extrêmement heureuse, c'est justement pour ce que tu racontes, le film de Maboula et le mien sont diamétralement opposés.
So I was really happy. I was actually really happy about this split prize because, as you said, the two films that were that received prizes are highly different films.
Et la première chose que je me suis dit, c'est bah, enfin les gens vont voir que deux femmes cinéastes, c'est pas pareil. Deux femmes cinéastes noires, c'est pas la même chose.
It was a good thing because I thought that it would show the diversity of black women filmmakers. That the people would at last realize that two women, two black women, could make movies and could make very different movies.
Parce que autant le combat sur la représentativité est un combat extrêmement important, extrêmement politique, sur notre représentativité en tant que femme noire faisant des films.
So representation for black women is of high significance.
Mais en fait, je ne veux pas que les gens nous réduisent à des femmes noires qui font des films. Je veux
But I don't want to be limited to the status of a black woman making movies.
Je veux revendiquer ma subjectivité, je veux revendiquer ma singularité.
I want to remain an individual.
Et c'est à partir de cette singularité-là que je fais des films et que je prends la parole.
And it's because of my personal, my individual subjectivity, it is from that standpoint that I make movies.
Et pour moi, le fait de ne pas me penser comme cinéaste, c'est une autre manière de m'invisibiliser, en fait, de me réduire à cette place.
So I think that when people do not, cannot envision me as a filmmaker, it is a way to make me invisible.
Moi, justement, je fais des films parce que j'ai du mal à prendre la parole. J'admire énormément les
I make movies because it's difficult for me to speak.
Il y a énormément des choses qui me révoltent en France, qui me mettent en colère, qui me, pour lesquelles j'éprouve de la violence.
There are a lot of things that I find outrageous in France.
Et le fait de faire des films, c'est une manière de la mettre en forme.
And making movies is my way to voice this inner rage that I have.
Et si on me nie ça, c'est on me nie. Moi, après les Césars, j'ai été beaucoup sollicitée pour devenir une forme de porte-parole.
So after this ceremony, I was asked a lot to, and I was, it's as if I was asked to become the spokesperson
pour parler de la banlieue, pour parler
to talk about the suburbs, the underprivileged suburbs.
Comme si j'étais une sociologue ou une journaliste.
As if I was a sociologist or a journalist.
Et je pense qu'il y a beaucoup de cinéastes blancs qu'on ne m'invite pas pour parler de choses. Et je trouve que c'est aussi une manière de nous. C'est aussi une forme de racisme inversé, en fait.
So I think that this is a form of racism. A lot of the white filmmakers are not asked to give their opinions on those matters.
Mais en tout cas, ce qui est très étrange, c'est que ces précautions, je les prends envers le monde blanc. C'est-à-dire, je leur dis, voyez-moi avant tout comme une cinéaste.
So I'm very cautious about that when it comes to the white world. I want them to see me as a filmmaker first.
Par contre, après les Césars, effectivement, moi, j'ai été une jeune fille et je me suis construite en n'ayant aucun modèle de représentation.
But when I was growing up, I didn't have any role models that looked like me.
J'ai rencontré énormément de jeunes femmes dans la rue après les Césars qui venaient me voir en me disant mais merci, c'est magnifique, ça nous a fait plaisir, on a pleuré en voyant la télé, des gens que je connais pas.
So after the ceremony, a lot of young people came to me and congratulated me about receiving this prize.
Et face à ces jeunes filles, je veux bien prendre le flambeau de la représentation méritocratique, ça je veux bien le prendre avec
vous. So when meeting those people and meeting these people and meeting those young black people, particularly black young women, I accept the role of the black filmmaker. Yes, I will accept that in front of them.
On n'attendra pas 30 ans pour des prochaines. Et je pense que c'est important qu'on soit nombreuses.
And my wish is that for France not to wait another 30 years to give prize to a filmmaker of color. And I can't wait for the other generation to come up. And it's very important for us to be as numerous as possible.
Et pour revenir sur ce que j'ai dit au moment des Césars, c'est qu'effectivement, moi, je suis la représentation et le fait d'être vue, c'est quelque chose qui est douloureux pour moi, c'est pas quelque chose qui est évident.
Okay, so to be watched, to be seen, is not something that I enjoy. It is something that is quite painful for me.
Je fais pas des films pour être vu. Enfin, c'est pour ça que je me cache derrière la caméra et je me cache derrière mes œuvres.
I don't make movies to be seen, and this is the reason why I hide behind the cameras.
Mais quand on a l'occasion d'être un haut-parleur, je ne voyais pas dire autre chose que de nommer ces garçons.
But when you get the opportunity to be a sort of loudspeaker, I didn't have any other choice than to name those boys.
Ces garçons, et pour moi c'était important de les nommer, qui sont scandaleusement et dramatiquement et injustement tués dans l'indifférence générale,
sans que personne, who are scandalously, unjustly, commonly killed by the authorities in France.
Et j'avais envie de rappeler de façon un peu provocante dans cette grande soirée du cinéma français, j'ai envie de mettre une injection de réel là-dedans en fait.
So I wanted to put some reality in this extremely staged ceremony gathering the industry, the cinema industry in France. I wanted to tell them. Because I like to.
I want to go back to the film and the title of the film. I don't agree that the tenderness is just about the lovemaking. I thought the very first clip of the young man standing in the corner, their group had a lot of tenderness, but they were like, they could be explosive if they didn't have each other and whatever they were doing. And I think that the tenderness was how you were able to approach them and get them to talk, not just because you were a woman. It had to have a different kind of, they had to be in a safe zone to say and do and show the vulnerability that they showed. And so I felt that the title was very, very apropos, and it seems like it must be a part of you.
Thank you, I'm very touched. Thank you. I don't know what to say.
Hi, first of all, thank you. Je vais essayer de m'adresser directement, si ça c'est peut-être plus facile. Je suis vraiment donc, pas francophone, donc peut-être... Ah non, 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 but then... No, sorry. Oh, wow.
Otherwise you'll make it.
Yeah. No, I completely missed that. Sorry. So my question is quite simple. So you say that, for instance, using the feminine voice allows for some kind of fragility, which helps the guys in getting comfortable with the questions asked and kind of relieve, I mean, diminishing some barriers in a way. But at the same time, they realized that it was a film that was being made, right? So I wonder to what extent they were worried about that. I mean, was there any reluctance there? And how did that maybe present a risk towards their fragility not really being completely, yeah, there?
Oui, non, en fait, effectivement, au départ, les voix n'étaient pas du tout censées devenir un film.
So the voices at first were not supposed to become a movie.
Donc ils se sont confiés librement sans penser à l'idée que cette parole allait devenir publique.
So this conversation was done, was carried out without the participants knowing or thinking that this would be turned into a film.
Mais moi non plus.
And I didn't think that it would either.
Et une fois que l'idée du film a germé en moi, dans ma tête, je les ai déjà, en fait, ce qui était, ils m'avaient demandé, un Rachid, moi là, c'est la deuxième voix qui me touche le plus personnellement, mais.
So the second voice is the voice that touches me the most.
Et il m'a demandé de réécouter l'entretien.
And so the second voice, Rachid, asked me to re-listen to this conversation, this recorded conversation.
Et quand il m'a appelé pour me demander, je pensais qu'en fait c'est parce qu'il assimilait pas ce qu'il avait dit, qu'il avait honte.
So I was worried that when he called me, I was worried that he would not take responsibility for what he said, that he would not own what he had said to me. That was my worry.
Et ça c'était bien avant même d'avoir l'idée de faire le film. Et en
And
tout
it
cas,
was long before considering making a film.
J'ai essayé de le rassurer et il m'a dit une chose qui m'a beaucoup touché.
So I tried to reassure him and he told me something.
Je lui ai dit, mais t'inquiète pas, tu sais, c'était très bien ce que tu as dit. Il me fait, mais là, j'ai envie de réécouter parce que ce que tu m'as dit, jamais aucune femme ne me l'avait dit.
Okay, so I tried to reassure him at first, but then he said something that really surprised me and touched me. He said, but what you told me during our conversation, no woman has ever told me that.
Alors quand j'ai décidé de faire le film, bien sûr que je leur ai informé, et tous étaient d'accord pour que j'utilise leur voix.
So when I decided to make a film out of these conversations, of course, I informed them that I would do so, and they all agreed.
Et bien sûr, les deux premières voix, en fait, c'est pas eux qu'on voit à l'image, c'est-à-dire le corps ne correspond pas à ceux qui m'ont parlé.
So for the first two voices, the men you see on the screen are different from the voices that you hear.
Pour Patrick et Alice, donc la troisième et la quatrième voix, bien évidemment, c'est eux qu'on voit et qu'on peut parler.
But for the two last voices, they match the people you see on the screen.
Et Patrick, c'était la première fois qu'il assumait de dire son homosexualité.
So Patrick basically came out on this screen. It was the first time that he discussed his homosexuality publicly.
Et c'était pour lui quelque chose d'hyper important que de l'assumer et que finalement le film, c'est marrant, je l'ai filmé dans un non-travelling qui traversait les endroits où on a grandi tous les deux, dans la cité où on a grandi.
J'ai même oublié le début de ta phrase.
Le travelling où je le filme, c'est les endroits où on a vécu. En fait.
So when you see him on the screen, he's going through spaces and the neighborhood where we both grew up.
Au fond, ça n'a aucune importance dans le film, personne ne le sait, mais quand même le fait d'avoir traversé le lieu de notre enfance comme ça, c'était une manière c'était quelque chose de très symbolique pour lui et pour moi.
So to walk through our old neighborhoods in the movie was very symbolic to both of us, even though the people you see around don't know about what's going on, but for Patrick and myself, it was really important to walk through those spaces where we both grew up.
C'était une manière de l'accompagner dans sa
so it was
dans sa révélation, enfin quelque chose.
It was a way for me to walk by his side and to support him in the process of his coming out.
Did the first two voices, did they not want you to use their image on film? Did they choose that or did you decide not?
Non, c'est moi. En fait, c'est moi qui ai décidé de ne pas utiliser leur.
I chose not to use the two first voices, bodies.
C'était un choix de moi, c'est un choix de mise en scène.
The decision came from me, not from,
pour les raisons que j'ai un peu évoquées tout à l'heure, mais aussi parce que filmer un groupe de garçons à l'image avec cette voix, finalement, qui, elle venait fendre aussi la représentation de la masculinité, de la virilité aussi. Et elle venait nous faire entendre autre chose.
So to film those men.
De mettre cette voix sur ce groupe de garçons.
So to voice over this group of men.
Ça venait casser, en fait, ça venait faire entendre quelque chose de leur...
was a way to shatter, was a way to challenge, was a way to question their masculinity.
C'est comme si à l'image on voyait une espèce de représentation hyper convenue de hyper stéréotypée.
What you see on the screen can be very conventional, very common, what you would see every day.
On voit dans tous les films, enfin des groupes de garçons qui squattent au pied des immeubles en fumant des joints, etc.
Okay, so the common images that get widely circulated with young men, young thugs hanging out in the ghetto, smoking spliffs.
Et en fait, la voix off venait, en fait, révélait la part insoupçonnée de leur personnalité. En fait.
And the voiceover was acted as kind of a revelation and was disclosing things that commonly do not match what we see.
Et précisément, ce que vous l'avez dit tout à l'heure, ce que ces garçons n'auraient jamais pu dire dans leur entre eux.
And the voiceover also highlighted what those young men would never tell one another.
Et c'est ça que j'avais envie d'interroger dans ma mise en scène.
And this is what I wanted to stage.
Yeah, I find this movie like so good, you know, it was so moving and brilliant, you know. I was like, but merci. It's very, very striking and very good. So I have a question about the traveling in Bruxelles, I think, with a prostitute, you know. You know, I just wondering, as a fiction, when you put this like a black lady at the end, why are you choosing a black woman?
And this is a question from a journalist and writer, Jean-Éric Poulain, from France.
J'utilise beaucoup un de vos livres. Enfin bref, c'est qui avait écrit l'annexe au récit national.
Ouais, supplément.
Oui, c'est ça. J'aime beaucoup ce.
I know your work, and I appreciate.
Vraiment, j'ai vraiment impressionné. C'est sublime. Votre film est vraiment sublime, c'est ça.
So this is the introduction. You can talk. He's more than films, and he's more than books.
Non, en fait, oui. En fait, moi, je ne connaissais pas du tout cette rue Gare du Nord de Bruxelles.
So I didn't know this particular street in Brussels.
Et en fait, j'y suis allée en repérage avec le groupe de garçons que j'ai filmé.
C'est rue de Bruxelles.
C'est à Bruxelles.
Oui.
Non, c'est à Bruxelles, c'est en Belgique. Là où les femmes sont exposées en vitrine, comme ça, comme des friandises.
Women are put on display behind windows.
Et j'étais très très choquée en fait de voir ça.
This was a real shock for me when I discovered.
Et ce qui m'a marqué, c'est que dans la rue principale, c'est que des femmes blanches, mais vraiment des avions de chasse ukrainiens. Enfin, c'est des femmes, c'est presque des robots.
So in the main streets, you will only find white women. White women. perfect European looking, if we understand European as white, European looking, very
bionic women.
Bionic women.
Et dans les rues annexes, c'était que des noirs et des vieilles.
And in the smaller streets, off main streets, you would only find black women and older women.
Donc elles étaient rangées dans l'arrière-boutique, quoi.
They were in the, at the back. That's what it meant symbolically.
Et du coup, moi, c'est vrai que voir cette image de femme en vitrine, c'est quelque chose, c'est une expérience en tant que femme qui est assez, assez folle en fait, mais sans aucun jugement. Mais vraiment, c'est quand même assez étonnant.
So as a woman, I was really surprised to see women put on display behind, you know, glass windows. It was.
Et en fait, j'avais envie d'inventer une. J'avais envie qu'une femme qui soit en vitrine soit comme une reine.
So I wanted to invent. I wanted to play with this idea of having a woman behind one of those glasses, and that would be like a queen.
Parce que la manière dont elle est filmée, son regard, la manière dont elle est habillée.
So the way I shot her, the way she looks at people, the way she is dressed.
Il y avait quelque chose pour moi qui disait, tu peux acheter mon corps, mais tu n'auras pas quelque chose de ma dignité en fait. Tu n'auras pas quelque chose, tu n'auras pas mon moi profond.
All this staging, to me, was supposed to indicate that yes, you can buy my body, but you cannot buy my dignity, and you cannot reach my inner self.
Et c'est ça que j'avais envie que l'image dise. Et aussi, j'avais envie que dans cet échange entre cet homme et cette femme.
So this is what I wanted the image to show.
Et que dans l'échange entre ce garçon et cette fille, dans le court temps où dure cet échange, il est presque impossible qu'on puisse imaginer ou qu'on puisse. Enfin, j'avais envie de rêver d'impossible, d'une rencontre possible, mais empêchée par cette vitre.
So in this brief exchange between this woman behind the glass window and this young man, I wanted people to be able to consider, to imagine a possibility that maybe in this brief exchange something could happen. But this is a sort of a failed encounter precisely because of the window.
Donc finalement, filmer une femme noire qui est en fait considérée dans l'inconscient, en tout cas à Bruxelles, visiblement comme une pute au rabais, c'était une
manière. So to film a black woman in Brussels, and in Brussels, as I said, these women do not appear on main streets. They appear on the lesser streets, and they are also cheaper prostitutes.
Donc c'était une manière de lui redonner de la puissance et de la dignité, et de le faire à la même chose avec le garçon qui la regarde.
So I wanted to give dignity, to give might to this woman, and simultaneously to give dignity and might to the young man looking at her.
Pourquoi ne pas avoir filmé les femmes, les prostituées noires qui étaient en vitrine, pourquoi ne pas avoir filmé elle également? Tu vois ce que je veux dire?
So why did for the audience? So why did not you film the other prostitutes, the black prostitutes? Why don't they appear in your film?
Parce que si je l'avais filmé, si j'avais capté le réel il aurait été moins puissant que cette scène-là, en fait.
Okay, so if it was about sticking to reality, reality would be less mighty than what I staged, precisely because of what I explained earlier. The reality is the fact that those women. I'm not translating, I'm interpreting. Perhaps you need fiction to fix reality, because the reality is that those black women do not appear on the main street. They're not the bionic women that we described earlier. So this is when fiction came to the rescue.
I've heard a parallel between, not that it's an incarnation, but a parallel between that one moment and the interweaving of your voice in the dialogues. The one black woman with that incredible, it is a quick moment, but it really sticks with you, and the way you interact vocally with them. Because another kind of look is possible. Just as you're talking to them, you say things that push them out of their comfort zone. Do you think you're lovable? Do you think you can be loved? You look at them. You see them, and you're not a potential one-night stand. You're not a potential object of desire in that exchange. And she also looks at them with a similar kind of power.
I think it's a very interesting point, but in that case, is the camera also the division? Does the camera makes it impossible, just like the window separates them? It's very true, thank you.
did it take to make the film?
Combien
de beginning to end.
Very quickly, très très court. Ça m'a pris une semaine le tournage.
So 1 week for shooting.
Et 6 semaines le montage. C'était plus compliqué.
Six weeks for editing. It was more complicated.
Et les voix, en tout cas, c'était très rapide parce que c'est chaque fois 2 heures avec les 4 garçons de discussion.
And for the voices, it was really it went very quickly because it was each time 2 hours for each voice.
Ouais.
Yes.
Je crois qu'il y avait une question.
Thank you so much. Yeah, you sort of already answered the question that I had. I was reflecting as you were talking about, I remember when I was in film school, actually, I went to Columbia and I haven't been back here since then, but I was reflecting on the opening of a movie called Contempt by Godard, and at the beginning there's a quote over a woman's body, and the quote is, cinema replaces the world with one that conforms to our desires. And that was what I was thinking about as you were talking. And I wondered if you could share whether or not you would agree that your movie does that. I was very moved listening to you. And I also just want, my second part of my question was, I would love to show this movie to my students. And is there a possibility that it will be available? And then if I do share that with them, would it be true to say that this was a movie that replaced reality with one that conformed to your desires?
Moi, j'ai mis des années à essayer de comprendre les phrases de Godard dans ce film. Ah, c'est de Bazin, André Bazin. Ah, c'est pas de Godard, c'est une phrase d'André Bazin. Et la phrase. Okay. Donc c'est le cinéma remplace le monde. C'est quoi exactement la phrase?
What is the sentence? What is the sentence?
It's from What is Cinema, and it's from Bazin, and he said cinema replaces the world with one that conforms to our desires.
Donc tu es d'accord. Yes, I agree.
Non mais en fait, ce qui est marrant, c'est que cette phrase, elle m'évoque non pas ce film, mais le prochain.
So this sentence makes me think not about this particular film, but my next one.
Et c'est en fait, vous n'êtes pas sans savoir qu'en ce moment, il y a énormément de conflits, de tensions très très fortes qui agitent la société française.
So there are a lot of tensions right now in France. There are a lot of tensions.
Et en fait, j'ai envie de faire un film qui serait une utopie. Tout à l'heure, Nora, tu citais le titre du film qui s'appelle Nous.
Okay, so my next movie, We or Us.
Us. Et en fait, l'idée du film, c'est de... C'est presque une utopie qui.
So this movie is a utopia.
Où j'ai envie de rapprocher des mondes en ce moment qui ne dialoguent absolument pas et qui s'ignorent.
A utopia about bringing together sections of French society that do not interact or that ignore one another, who do not know one another.
Et presque que l'espace de ce film sera un espace d'un dialogue qui n'a même pas lieu en dehors de cet espace-là en fait.
So I'm trying to invent a conversation that is simply not taking place in France right now.
Donc c'est là où je rejoins complètement la phrase d'André Bazin.
So this is where I agree with the quote that you have mentioned. The quote by Bazin.
Je suis ravi que vos étudiants de Columbia puissent.
But I would be very happy for your students to watch this movie.
D'accord.
This film.
So just on
all, I want to say thank you for this movie. I was really moved by it and by what you say right now. I mean, I'm very moved by that, and thank you for everything. And I wanted to know what the voice, if they saw the movie, and what does they think about it? What does it tell you? What did they tell you after that?
Merci beaucoup. Oui, ils ont vu le film, la première projection du film qui a eu lieu à Paris.
Thank you for this question. They have seen the movie and they saw it at the first screening that took place in Paris.
Ils étaient tous les quatre dans la salle.
All of them were in the room.
Et moi, je voulais pas, je les ai pas présentés parce que je savais pas quel degré de ils avaient envie qu'on sache qu'ils avaient participé au film.
So they were all in attendance, but I did not introduce them formally because I didn't know to which extent they wanted to be recognized publicly.
Et ils ont été extrêmement bouleversés par les réactions des gens dans la salle.
And they were totally overwhelmed by the audience reactions.
Parce qu'ils se sont sentis écoutés, et moi j'avais extrêmement peur qu'on les juge. Et en fait, ils se sont sentis écoutés et pas jugés.
They felt they had been heard and not judged.
À tel point d'ailleurs que à la fin de dans le générique de fin, Steve, donc c'est un des personnages d'un précédent documentaire que j'ai fait, qui s'appelle Steve Chenche, et je l'ai appelé Régis dans le parce que comme il est comédien, j'avais pas spécialement envie, enfin je savais pas trop s'il fallait que je le protège ou pas. Et il m'a dit, mais dis que c'est Steve Chenche, il voulait absolument que je remette son nom.
So the point that one of the voices, one of the men whose name is Steve Chenche, who's actually an actor, he told me why didn't you put my real name in the credits? You should have credited me properly.
Quant à Patrick, par exemple, il fait énormément de projections, il accompagne énormément le film.
And Patrick, one of the voices, does a lot of screenings and Q&A around this film.
I just want to say thank you for the film. It was very moving because as I was watching the film itself, I felt this disconnect between sometimes the experience of what it's like just to be alive in this world in terms of the kind of representation that you put on as opposed to what's really going on inside your heart and mind. And it's also a reminder for me as a woman to continue to be compassionate to women who are both older and younger, of different ethnicities, of different backgrounds, different religious faiths, just because there's a lack of understanding on the international scale. So just thank you for that reminder to be compassionate to people across the board, including the men, the male gender sometimes, which can be really frustrating. So thank you for that reminder.
Merci beaucoup.
I wanted to, what is the impact on you as a, I'm not sure where you're from in the world, but what's the impact on you to be at the front row of what's going on in France when it comes to the lack of unity?
Je me dis que heureusement que j'ai l'espace du cinéma pour pouvoir combler ces frustrations et ces angoisses. Et
so thank God I have cinema. I make movies to deal with those frustrations, those tensions.
Cette violence qu'on subit chaque jour et cette violence de pas être, enfin on a l'impression de enfin c'est très compliqué la France hein, pour
France is very difficult but cinema allows me ways to cope with this constant violence.
Je sais pas comment on pouvait l'entendre vous aux États-Unis mais de parler des questions raciales, de parler du racisme en France, c'est extrêmement dur, extrêmement compliqué.
To talk about race and racism is very very difficult in France.
Et je pense que ça rend les fous en fait. Je pense
and I think it literally drives people crazy.
De dire nous notre expérience c'est ça et d'en voir des gens en face qui nous disent non vous mentez, non c'est pas vrai.
We're saying that this is what our experiences are like and people in front of you are just saying no it's not true.
Donc en fait pour moi faire des films c'est pas tellement faire des films de procureurs qui des films à charge.
So I make movies not to I don't know press charges.
Yeah.
Brent Edwards approval.
Mais en tout cas voilà c'est essayer de raconter notre expérience et de faire en sorte que à partir de cette expérience on puisse et éprouver de l'empathie et voir des choses qui nous concernent.
So I'm trying to tell stories and I'm trying to describe our experiences and my hope is that by telling those narrating those experiences, people can have empathy.
Aussi puisse se reconnaître, c'est-à-dire que ça puisse être.
And that the people can be can see themselves reflected in those stories and also for those stories to become truly universal. Voilà.
Sorry, no question. I just wanted to.
It has to be very brief because this.
Very brief. So I just wanted to say congratulations. Your film actually played at the Nova Frontier Film Festival in September in Brooklyn, and you won, and we have the award
oh,
here.
So
merci beaucoup, thank you very much.
Closing the event, thank you very much for attending. Thank you very much, Alice Diop, for accepting this invitation. Thank you very much, Brent Edwards, for accepting this invitation as well and participating in this conversation. I want to say a few personal thank yous because this is my last screening and Q&A. So thank you very much to La Maison Française and all the team, including Chenny Pierre, including Marceau and Alex. Thank you very much for the invitation that was extended to me by Nora Philippe. Thank you, Columbia University. It's always good to be back. And this was a great opportunity to do this film series in Paris. Hopefully it will happen in Paris, but it means a lot I think people need to understand that it can sometimes be easier to have such events in New York than in Paris. So it's great, we're here on, enjoying ourselves, and but we're still struggling to have such great and ambitious and with such prestigious participants and people who are willing to share their understanding of the movies we have watched together. So this is precious to me. I want to say thank you to Shani, and I want to say thank you to Nora Philippe. I wanted to thank publicly Farah Griffin, whose scholarship is simply extraordinary. And I also want to thank Brent Hayes Edwards for your work. Brent is a person who's supposed to be your colleague, but you think of him as your master. You know, it's very uncomfortable. So thank you, everyone, and thank you, all of you, for attending. Please continue. The film series goes on another week, and join us. Join at least Alice Diop on Monday for the masterclass where she'll discuss the project that we mentioned earlier, us, right? This utopia of conversations not taking place in France right now, but that maybe with your images, people will think about having those conversations. So thank you, and good evening.